Hi, I'm Mona, and if you're here, you found Kaleidoscope Dreams Tarot. This is an I felt like it read, which is timeless. I would like to say, please do not live your life by the tarot. It is you who creates your own destiny. You are intelligent, beautiful or handsome, and you are kind. These readings may or may not resonate. Please subscribe, like, and share these videos. Somebody may be enlightened by them. Also, to my subscribers, welcome back. And to any new subscribers, welcome to the channel. I'm so glad you're here. You are the backbone to this channel, and I greatly appreciate you. So, yeah. I'm going to do the runes again. I love these, you guys. These give out really good messages, all right? So we're going to find out on this I felt like it read. What is going on here? When it comes to the runes, right? Let's go ahead and pull one rune for the challenge. Sorry, overview. Challenge. Action. Sacrifice. And what this situation brings. New situation. Now the energy of one of the people here is, energy of another person here is, and the energy of the entire situation is, oops, that was a rune. There we go. All right, you guys. So the overview of the situation. All right. So we have wholesomeness, right? The overview of this entire situation is wholesomeness. Now, wholesomeness, we find happiness here, right? This is about the sun. It's about life force. It's about victory. So this whole situation is victorious. This whole overview. Somebody is victorious in something that's going on here. All right? What's the challenge? So the challenge is they're not receiving the signals that they want, right? They're not receiving positive signals, possibly, or maybe confused. They might be receiving some sort of confusing signals, signals that they just cannot read, all right? And that's what the challenge is here. It also could be that someone's not using their intuition, accepting signals from the universe, from spirit. They're not accepting them. They're not seeing them. So something is blocking somebody from seeing or from receiving this wholesomeness in their life. Now, this could be coming from toxic people, toxic activities, toxic substances, but something is holding someone back from receiving this light, this sun, this life force, this victory, right? That's what the challenge is. And in order for them to do that, you gotta get rid of whatever it is that's, you know, preventing you from seeing these signals. Now, if spirit's trying to give you some signals on some things, you know, spirit's not gonna give you signals if you're all drunk or high or jacked up, right? Or if you're in a bad mindset, toxicities. You know, spirit is not going to, you know, allow you to see those signals. The signals might be being sent, but spirit is not allowing somebody here to receive any signals. Why? And it could be because there's something that's clouding their judgment. There's something in the way. There's something that's preventing. I'm feeling, what is it? Closed third eye and crown chakra. All right. That's what's happening here. Right? They're unable to see the way. See the truth, the way, right? So what action is this person going to take? All right. This is the Warrior Stone, right? Now, with this Warrior Stone, this is about a victory in battle, but it's in the reverse, you guys. So there will be no victory when it comes to this action, right? And it's the reason why is because they're not seeing the signs, right? Their eyes are closed right now, so they cannot see the signs. There's something preventing someone here from seeing the signs and signals from the universe in order to bring them wholeness. So there could be another person or other entities here trying to prevent this person from this. Mm-hmm. Trying to prevent them from seeing signals from the universe so they can have this happy wholeness in their life. Something or someone or a group of people or a situation is preventing someone from this. It could be a toxic activity also. So let's go ahead and check out what sacrifice is going to be made here. All right. So the sacrifice to be made is that somebody needs to pass through some particular type of gateway, right? There's something in this person's life that is causing an imbalance. It's causing them to not be able to have this happiness and joy and victory life force that they deserve, right? Somebody may even see themselves victorious with a certain person. But because they're in the energy of not receiving signals, right? And also not having the strength to be a warrior, to brave through whatever this is that's holding them back from seeing the truth, the way, right? So, you know, the action here is they have to take a step. The sacrifice is they have to take a step through this gateway in order to finally see the truth, which means to rid themselves of toxic situations, toxic peoples, toxic habits, whatever it is that is preventing their chakras from opening up and receiving messages from the universe, right? The only way you can receive messages is if you have a clear mind, clear body. You know, and that's when your soul starts to show. And that's when you start to read your own soul and realize who you are and what you're doing. Right? So somebody must pass through the gateway. And they will. That's the action to be taken. So somebody may seek help to help open the chakras. Somebody, and you know what? I'll tell you what, you guys. Many, many years ago, not very many, at least over five, but years ago, I went to a reader, psychic type of person, and they told me that all my chakras were closed, and the only one that was open was my throat chakra, all right, that everything else was gray, and in order for them to help me, they would need like $200 just to be a person that goes there regularly, and $600 for some candles, and another $600. The money was adding up. Somebody was trying to dupe me. And so I ended up leaving that day, kind of agreeing to go along with this, but then the woman disappeared. Like, I could not get a hold of her anymore. I couldn't find her. I couldn't reach her over the phone. So that to me was a sign from spirit that that person was deceptive, not to trust that person. Like, thank goodness I didn't give all that money. I didn't have it anyways, you know, but I was agreeing to it. But then I couldn't find her, you know, because eventually I could have paid it if I wanted to, if I wanted to could take this process. But I figured it out myself that I can do this myself, that I don't need another person to heal me, right? Because you can't heal the world. Right? A person has to want to heal in order to heal. So I made that change in my life that I wanted to change myself. I wanted to heal. And this person might be having that kind of epiphany or idea that they do want to walk that path. They want to walk the path of virtuosity, walk the path of, enlightenment, right? They want to know. They want to change their life. They want to open up those chakras, right? Now, once they do that, let's find out the energies of who we got here first, though, okay? Because we do know we have the energy of one person who's got some closed chakras, is not receiving messages from the universe. They want wholeness and happiness in their life, but they're unable to do that. They don't have the strength to do that, They're weak inside. So there could be addictions. It could be addictions. But like I said, you can't change anyone. They gotta want to change. And it looks like this person may want to change. They may want to change because they want to go through, they want to go through this gateway to a better reality. So when it comes to this person, who do we have here? We have a fox, right? Cleverness and adaptability. This person can adapt. Somebody here can adapt. They're very clever. I'm also seeing there is a person who's clever who may try to act like they're going to fix themselves, like they're going to, be able to do this. They might be hiding addictions, hiding negative activities. Hiding, like the criminal activities even. I'm hearing criminal. This other person involved here, we have the dolphin, right? This is such a beautiful stone too. It's like a blue sandstone type of thing, right? But, we got the dolphin right here. And the dolphin is about harmony and wisdom. Right? And I feel that this is, something that somebody already has obtained for themselves, harmony and wisdom, right? So we have one person, this clever person who may try to act like they are whole, they're whole, and that they are cured and healed and happy and all this and everything's going, but they're being a clever little fox. Why? Because they don't have the power to step away from whatever this toxicity in their life is. They're not being a warrior when it comes to that, right? This is a warrior stone. They're not strong enough. So somebody might need some professional help, maybe because they can't do it on their own. And I'll tell you what, addictions are mental. They are mental. I've had several addictions throughout my lifetime. Not like, I was addicted for a week or two. No, for years, okay? But I stepped into my own light. I didn't even need to go to rehabs or anything like that. I just got up one morning and I was like, I'm sick of this life. I'm sick of what's going on here and I'm stopping and it ends right now. And that's how it ended. That's just how it did. Some people have a strong will like that. Some people are in the upright warrior position at all times in their life. Some people are not. Some people need assistance. Okay. So the situation, the energy of this entire situation is the deer. And the deer represents sensitivity and peace. So somebody is going to probably try to come in. But because one of the people are already enlightened to whatever's going on, you can't be too clever with this person because this person has already gone through those phases of cleverness. They know, right? They have the smarts now. They receive signals. They are a warrior. But this person, not so much. But you can't hide it from. Look at them looking at each other. You can't hide that from each other. They both know each other so well. And that's why this person might be even having a hard time coming in. But they want sensitivity and peace. Maybe somebody here realizes they want to heal. And they're coming to this person for that help. Harmony and wisdom. Right? But I do feel that there is going to be some sensitivity and peace between these two, because somebody may come forth and say, look, I need your help. I need help. There's nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong with somebody seeking help from another person, because maybe they just don't know how to do it. Maybe they don't have the money to go to, rehabs cost money. Maybe they don't have enough money to go to rehab. Maybe they don't want to tell anybody. They don't want to tell anybody they're going through this. They want to do it secretly. Somebody might come to you and say secretly, look, I really want to change my life. I really want to do this. Can you help me? Somebody might come to another person and say that. Let's see what the end of the situation is. This is initiation. All right. This is uncertain, right? This is a secret matter, right? But it's in the reverse, so it is no secret. So somebody is possibly going to come, they're going to come to another person and they're going to divulge all kinds of information. They're going to say they want to heal. They're going to, you know. Somebody is not sure, or somebody is sure now, sorry. Somebody is sure now what they want to do. The meaning is not uncertain. It is certain somebody wants to change. But they don't want the world to know that they've been going through this, right? So maybe there's a lot of people out there that are working with somebody. They don't know that this person is living in toxicity. And they're hiding it. This clever little fox is hiding it from everybody. But this person is ready to change. They're ready to change their life. And they're coming to somebody for help. Somebody who has a lot of wisdom. Who's very sensitive and peaceful. Because maybe the people in their life are just not peaceful. And they tend to turn back to whatever toxic activities they were doing. Because they just can't deal with these people. These people don't understand. Somebody here is becoming enlightened to this whole entire situation. And they want to change. They don't want to deal with this no more. So that's what I have for you guys. If it resonated, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Also, keep it true love energy. Happy, friendly, loving types. We have nothing to fear as long as we stay calm and cheerful, right? Mm-hmm. I'm Mona. This is Kaleidoscope Dreams Tarot. And I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye.